Hi everybody, it's Coach Ali. I'm here with Stephanie, and we're gonna show you three essential exercises that you need in your routine to improve that booty. Let's do this. All right guys, your first exercise is a deadlift. Now you can see we're using a deadlift machine which forces you to hinge your hips correctly, which is exactly what a deadlift is designed to do. The main thing here is to keep your spine nice and neutral and just make sure that you're feeling that flexion in the hamstrings, in the glutes, and in your erectors as well. So this is basically a posterior exercise that limits how much pressure you're getting on your quadriceps. If you're getting too much pressure on your quadriceps, it's because you're doing the exercise wrong. A great alternative here, if you don't have a deadlift machine, is to simply use a barbell. Now, you can see the barbell goes straight up and down, so it's only vertical movement as far as the barbell is concerned. It's your butt that's pushing back, so the way you would do it is pretend you're trying to touch the wall behind you with your butt. Allow the barbell to only move vertically throughout the exercise. Now, what happens if you don't have a barbell? You can also do this exercise simply with a weight plate. So the weight plate is held in front of you. Again, we're looking for that hinging movement, not a whole lot of bend in the knees, and just making sure that you're really squeezing with your glutes on your way up. You can replicate this same movement with kettlebells, even with a single dumbbell. Whatever you've got handy that's heavy and held in front of you, you can do these deadlifts with. Okay, let's move to the next exercise. So we have a hips thruster. So you're lifting your glutes, pushing your hips up towards the ceiling. Now, this is another exercise that really engages the hamstrings, the glutes, and the erectors, particularly in the upper glutes. So this is going to create that really nice shape that you're after. The focus is to push your hips up as far as it'll go. Try to hold that high position for a split second, really get that flexion in the muscles, and then drop it back down into its relaxed position. Now, if you don't have a hip thruster machine, again, you can do this with a flat bench and a barbell. It's a typical way of doing it, and it's how a lot of people do it at home or in the gym. The movement is identical, so you can see that the feet are set parallel at shoulder width. The knees are right above the feet, and it's just a matter of really squeezing up and getting those hips up as far as it'll go. Now, if you don't have your barbell and bench, another good home alternative is just to use a Swiss ball and again, a weight plate. So we can replicate exactly the same motion with simple tools that you can find at home. Now, when you're using a Swiss ball, really important, the Swiss ball does not move. You've got to try and control that Swiss ball and maintain its motion. And again, you're really focusing on just pushing those hips up as far as they'll go. The third move that you're gonna need in your arsenal is a donkey kick. So a really good way of doing this at the gym would be to use a Smith machine because it allows you to control where your foot position goes. So you can really work on the range of movement and just get that donkey kick right up. Now, you can see there's no movement in the upper body. The hands are nice and sturdy and it's supporting the body. And the toes are pointing back, so we don't want any weird angles when you're doing this. Now, a good home alternative would be to just use some loop bands. So if you don't have access to a Smith machine, get your loop band out and just try and replicate exactly the same movement. Again, you want to make sure that your toes are pointing back and your lift is nice and clean. And just try and get as much range as you can for this movement. Now, if you don't have loop bands, but you have dumbbells, you can replicate exactly the same thing. So it's just a matter of gripping the dumbbell with your plantaris, with the back of your knees, and just trying to hold it in place and squeezing right up. Now you're gonna find with this version, you're gonna get a little bit more flexion in your hamstrings because you're trying to manage the dumbbell as well. Anyway, these are three exercises you need to get that major booty transformation. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. We've got a lot more of this sort of thing coming up.